I'm Hans, and then this is Maps. So this is called Group and Boiler Coffee Co. And we started around June this year.
We offer coffee, and then we have our own signature beverages, as well as coffee cocktails. And apart from that, we also have food selections such as pastries, cakes, cookies.
Our coffees are between 110, starting at 110, up to 150. Our signature beverages are at around 180. And we have our coffee cocktails as well, which are between 200 to 250. Target market is, we wanted to capture a wide range of ages and generations. Since we're in the specialty coffee industry, it tends to be narrow or too niche. So we're trying to make specialty coffee more accessible within most age brackets. Well, in Group and Boiler, we like to be very casual. Casual and authentic. So like here, all the partners and even the staff are very genuine. We try not to like stick to a script rather. So when we engage with our customers, we really genuinely interested with what they do. We ask them what their field is, and we ask them what they're looking for, and we essentially try to create friendships with them. We want to build a community rather with everybody. So essentially, apart from just looking like a home, we want them to feel at home as well.
Welcome, Hans and Maps. You have 3 minutes to make or break your brand to our panel of experts by choosing to show what you have as the best of your product and your business model. Well, the floor is yours.
If you're familiar with specialty coffee, so there's this movement now called like a third wave movement. So it's basically making coffee artisanal rather than just a basic commodity. And so we realized the industry has existed in the Philippines for quite a while now. Like the latest possible time it started was 2013. And it was intimidating to most people. And that's why until now, we have a lot of small independents rather than large chains. There are a few, but not really too many, not as popular as some other brands. So we wanted to make this thing, we wanted to make Group and Boiler a little more
approachable. Yeah. And something friendly for other people rather than it's just a place for coffee people. Mm-hmm. So we want to cater to everyone.
You got the environment, the coffee.
Haven't
palace.
We had enough coffee? I mean, sorry, but
you've had enough coffee.
I'm just wondering why coffee, and what's a USP? What's really the
I think they're asking for differentiation. Yeah.
The reason why we put up in Alabang was it was the one area that could use a little more. Offerings, more selections. Mm-hmm. So that's why we decided that would be our first branch, so that at least we don't get into the oversaturated market like cities like Makati and BGC. There's a lot of competition there, and so we wouldn't be able to like set our roots there too easily.
So aside from the look and feel of the coffee shop itself, how different is the taste of your coffee from the other specialty?
At the end of the day, it boils down to the product, right?
Yeah. Well, we like to say that you can drink our coffee without the sugar, especially even if you're a sweet tooth.
Mm-hmm. So this one has no sugar.
No sugar. None of those.
But how is it flavored then in that case?
Our blend, we designed it in a way that would be friendly to most palates. So it's it has like a chocolate,
cherry
and almonds, like roasted almond flavor, mm-hmm. all on its own. That's without syrups, no additives.
And that's with the roasting process and the beans.
Yes, and yes, then you add the vodka and the
that's for our cocktails.
The cocktails is actually more of, it just came along the way. We were thinking about it as it went. And then, okay, what else can we offer apart from just coffee? Which where it comes in, right, the differentiation. Mm-hmm. So we were like, okay, we can play around with coffee cocktails. I mean, it's not that we didn't invent it, mm-hmm. but like the selections around are very minimal.
How much is one cup?
A cup of coffee, let's say, starts at 110, which is either your double espresso or your long black, or also known as the Americano.
The one with whiskey.
The one with the whiskey. well, we have...
You can tell his priorities.
Yeah. So we
I'm a grown up.
We have the espresso old-fashioned, which uses the whiskey, uh-huh. and we have the espresso Irish. So those are around Essentially, our coffee cocktails range between 200 to 250 per serving.
It's very interesting that when you were starting your spiel, your pitch, you were saying the two of you don't have anything in common yet. Look at your outfit.
Yeah, I was going to ask, is there a couple?
That's a valid question, especially when it comes to founders.
And because you're a couple and you're into business together, what are the ways that you're making sure that the relationship is not affected by whatever that's happening in the business?
What are your terms of engagement?
At the onset, before we even started thinking about a business, or we had to tell each other, okay, this is where we draw the line between relationship and business.
Written on paper, or
it's our mutual agreement.
It's a mutual agreement.
Yes. Unwritten
Nobody.
Law.
It's our unwritten law. At the end of the day, business is business, and then our relationship is separate.
What are your advice when it comes to
relationships?
In business, not relationships, maybe from James. In terms of being in business with your friends, with your loved ones, or with your family members?
Loved one, you.
Well, me, I do work with my friends and my girlfriend, and it sounds like a great idea for everyone to be able to start a business with your friends and with your partner. I think what's really important is that you just share the same passion. You all have the same idea, same vision of where you want to take it, and I think that's the most important. Also, you need to have like a chain of command. There has to be one, so there's accountability and responsibility for everyone.
Yeah.
I just threw it out there. What if somehow along the way that idea for the business changes? I mean, businesses are very dynamic and something changes along the way.
You've got to evolve the environment.
And when you have different visions, what do you do?
Oh, well, actually, we started with something, with a very humble idea. Rather than having a full-fledged store, it was more of just like, so, like our first idea was just getting something really small and then subleasing with another store and then just kind of making it work from there. So it was very informal. Just like, it was just an idea, a dream rather. Mm-hmm. And then, so at that point we were working on our business model so we could pitch to investors. And when we found our investors, they were saying there's only one problem. Your vision's too small. So we're like, okay, so we're going to make this a big thing. Fine, let's do it. Make a whole store.
Well, and you don't fight. What's you that? Don't fight.
With who?
Safe answer.
Arguing is arguing is healthy in a sense, especially if it's for the better of the business.
So you don't fight?
Not so much anymore as before.
Not as much as before.
I mean,
so they matured because of the business.
Actually, no, this is financial implications.
Yeah. I have a question. Who's the boss? Remember James talked about the chain of command. You're the boss.
Oh, well, I'm president. And this
But president or?
President, vice president.
No, seriously, I mean, who really
makes the decisions?
Leads the company.
Well, me.
Yeah, because I think it's really important. And I don't know, but I don't want the stereotypical that you should not be working with friends, family, or not with loved ones, etc. It really depends on your risk appetite and your personality.
Yes. And cuentas claras dapat. You have to be clear rules to each other.
But I can't work with somebody really close to me.
Okay.
I'm different. I can't focus.
These are really practical bits of advice. James, Sal, the parting words for our pitchers.
I think it should really go beyond passion, that profit should be there to sustain it. At the end of the day, if we can't monetize whatever good things that we like to do, we'll end up starving and begging for people's recognition. So make sure that you are focused not just on whether the vision is small or not. Who cares? As long as you're passionate about it, go for it.
Yes. Definitely.
Definitely.
Yeah, from what I gather, it sounds like you're trying to make a community around your coffee and your shop. That's what you're trying to build, like a small community of people and friends. And I like that idea. So I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Thanks, James. Thank you. Salve.
I think it's very important that you think about differentiation because as Mon pointed out a while ago, there are so many coffee shops already.
Yes.
And there are big ones. Even in the show, we've had so many entrepreneurs pitch ideas about coffee, Thai coffee, all sorts of specialty coffee. But if you want to turn into an experience, maybe it's something that will help you grow your business more. Do research, in-depth research on your target market. Make sure that you know your finance as well.
Oh, yes.
And make sure that you don't fight. Or when you fight, make sure that you resolve it before you end the day.
Oh, yeah.
All right, panelists, thank you very much. I mean, just to sum up, you've got clear rules of engagement between the two of you, given your relationship.
Yes.
But also the idea that when you start scaling up, you've got to know your numbers, what it takes to produce a single cup of coffee, your coffee variants, because you're not going to be restricted in Alabang for long if you keep this up. So with that, all the best, Hands and Maps.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.